We're here in Las Vegas at my library, and because so many people are interested in my educational background or kind of like what I've learned in terms of business and how I learned all the business skills I've learned, I want to talk about it because I've learned so much from being in the field, but so much of it was from mentors, people that have advised me, and also from books. So one of the students on my YouTube channel, he said, what are the books that have inspired you? Well, I decided that since I'm in my library, I might as well do a video about those books that have been influential to me. So I chose a half dozen of those books. So let's go through some of them. So the first one is probably the book that I talk about the most. This is 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen Covey. Now this book here is probably one of the most influential books in my entire life, because before this, I used to be really, really interested in, say, business or like work for like schoolwork, or I might be interested in just spending all my time socializing and partying. But this is a book that allowed me to focus on, say, principles, developing those values in your life that kind of guide you, and having those principles kind of guide your whole life. So it wasn't about me losing focus or balance in my life. And that was huge because I used to be a workaholic. I also used to spend too much time focusing on business, or I'd be angry if I was not spending enough time on one particular thing, whether it's business or it's my social life or it's my hanging out with my family. And this is kind of like the book that kind of changed that. I know they offer tons of seminars. My business, we always have like tons of huge issues, sometimes contentious issues. I know that they have seminars, one of which my father went to, and they got a gavel. And the gavel was passed out to members of the board. They were in their board meetings and there was a contentious issue and someone felt like someone was going off track or they're yelling, they would slam the gavel down. And I don't do that, but I mean, the principles that were talked about in this book also were really influential for my board meetings and also for Tower. The main principle being seek first to understand before being understood. So if you listen to other people's needs and concerns before speaking your own, I still need to remind myself of that many, many times. Because in business, so many times your life changes and goes on different paths. Now, some of the other books I found really interesting was a book from one of my wife's advisor, who became a good advisor, a friend of mine, was The Goal. This is basically a book that is more like a story. It's a plot that talks about how in life, there's so many different business elements and they come up and they basically mix things up. But it's a story about an industrial plant where they're talking about what's money and what's really making money. And the key principle from the bottom line is that you're only as powerful as your weakest link. And so this is a book that kind of measured how to track that. And it was about a guy who goes into a plant. He thinks his company's making tons of money. He's realizing that it's making a very, very small margin. And he tinkers with his company based on what his weakest link is and makes his weakest thing stronger and stronger and stronger in the company, so he makes a ton of profit. Now, the other books I chose were books that were written by people that are really influential as businessmen in and of themselves. It's kind of like their autobiography, but this one is probably the least autobiography. It's a book that's called Ready, Fire, Aim, but by Michael Masterson. This is an amazing guy. He talks about how going from $0 to $100 million is possible, what he did to make that happen, and basically like the difference of a small company, like a company doing less than $1 million for a company doing 1 to 10 million and 10 to 100 million, and how you need to view your company differently and how he's viewed the company differently. Another one was Tony Hsieh's autobiography, which was Delivering Happiness. He talks about how he built his corporate culture. It's also really fun for me to read relatable books, books about people's lives and how they got their education, just like how people were here asking me, like, what was involved with my education? I love reading successful stories of successful people. Ever since I was a kid, I'd read these books. You know, whether it was from people who built newspapers or people who built large tech enterprises or became investment bankers. It was a story of reading these different stories that inspired me. Now, one of those is this book here by Howard Schultz. It's about how he created Starbucks. And I actually ended up having dinner with this guy. I thought it was pretty cool to read about someone and then meet them and share stories about that. But I also have loved reading books about Richard Branson, Losing My Virginity, the story of the DuPont family, the story of William Randolph Hearst, the stories of business people, even though not all of them are as, say, content rich as Michael Masterson's books, just kind of seeing the commonalities, like where they went to school, their formal education, especially their formal education, because I think a lot of people will discount that. I have friends who will argue about whether formal education is useful, whether it's not useful. One of them is Michael Ellsberg, who wrote a book about how formal education is not necessary. That's true. I grew up hearing the exact opposite, that formal education was a must to get any success. I don't believe that one or the other is acquired. I myself have gone through tons of formal education, but there's a ton of value through reading books and also a lot of value in self-education. So let's go into the topic of formal education versus self-education, because that's the second question that someone was asking me on the channel. They're saying, so what is your opinion about self-education versus formal education? Well, I've spent a ton of time in both formal education and just learning from the field, just going through internships. So I mean, ever since I was a kid, every single summer I would be doing internships. Even throughout my formal education at like Wisconsin, I was still doing internships or I was volunteering for various organizations, whether it was like a political campaign for a politician or working just for like a random company. I love the idea of just volunteering and getting my credentials up, getting my street cred, say, and work experience, because just working, even if it's not like the most complex tasks, just show you how the real world operates. So when you're involved with, say, the real world of education, that's so much different than formal education, because you'll study all sorts of advanced, different techniques and tactics, business tactics, marketing tactics, financial statements. For example, in accounting classes, I've taken maybe like 6 or 7 accounting classes. I'll study all sorts of ways of doing depreciation or ratios, asset test ratios, different financial statements in corporate finance classes. And most of this won't apply to my business, especially since some of it is involved with companies that have nothing to do with my company. Now, of course, in formal education, you'll study all sorts of things that you might not think about. So I love the idea of liberal arts educations, because I get my mind expanded in terms of my communication. I never thought about attending classes on interpersonal communications until I was in school. I was interested in learning about how people develop relationships. And now I developed a lot more skill sets in terms of relationships, relationship building, just from actually doing it myself. So that's where the self-education experience comes in. Me throwing parties, me doing events, me working as part of teams, I learned so much more about interpersonal communication, but understanding like the formal terms and thinking about things in terms of like modules or concepts or like pieces. For example, the idea that I could clarify expectations and avoid social violations. Now, that's like a technical catchphrase that I'll say a lot, because I studied it for like weeks in this one class about interpersonal communications and the concept of making sure everyone knows, understands what it is that you're thinking about in advance. Yeah, that's a very simple concept, but the idea that you could study case study after case study after case study and actually see it in real life was great, because it allows me to avoid a lot of mistakes. So the thing I like about formal education is that you'll read about, in like Harvard law cases, for example, or Harvard business study cases, you'll read about all these cases that have to deal with businesses that have failed. They've gone down a certain path and it didn't work out. These are paths that I might have taken myself. And by studying it in a formal environment, I'm taking years off my learning curve. That's why I believe in having mentors. Now, law professors, they don't actually have that self-education experience. They'll just read it from textbooks, but still, it's better than nothing. I prefer going also a lot though through not just the formal education in terms of university experience, how most people view formal education. I love doing it through mastermind groups, because I love the idea of working with people that have real field experience in the real world. Now, if you go to undergraduate education, a lot of what you learn is about liberal arts, because they want you to have that background of knowing that you've studied all sorts of things in the sciences, maths, arts, and everything, just so they know that you have that basic foundation. And that in the real world and business world, there's not just a narrow scope. Like if you just study like business school, for example, I went to business school, but if you just study business, for example, you might only just study marketing, finance, and what have you. But the idea that you have all these other things under your background allows you to think more outside the box. You can't really think outside the box, unless you know what the box is first. So, I mean, in the business world, you have this box, but in the liberal arts education, you have a larger box. You have a box that includes all these different things. So when you develop a product or service, the ability to have this broad range of understanding of topics around the world, that's why I think formal education is useful. It allows you to create solutions to problems that you wouldn't typically have thought of. So, I mean, for example, if I was going to create a marketing campaign that involved music, well, the fact that I studied music and got an appreciation for the arts is cool. Now, you could get a lot of that just from like hiring people that are really good at these various activities, but I love the concept that you have some knowledge and skill sets under your belt among these different kinds of disciplines, because you're more prone to basically make the right decisions. If you just hire a bunch of people that you think are smart, you're just not necessarily knowing if these people who say they're smart are actually smart, they actually know what they're talking about. So that's why I really love the idea of not just formal education, but also travel. Travel, I believe, is part of self-education because it allows you to expose yourself to cultures and experiences that other people in the world are doing. So I, on a self-education level, have gone to businesses, have reached out to CEOs of companies or managers of companies and taken tours of their businesses to understand what they are more clearly. That's why I also wanted to share tours of businesses that belong to people that I interview with you as well, because I believe that by seeing the inner workings of a business, that self-education is super valuable. Some of the TV shows out there that are, say, reality shows will try to do that as well, but I think a lot of the times they're created and produced by producers, not businessmen who know what are actually learning lessons. It'll be like small like catchphrases like, wow, look at this person who related to this janitor and then they learned a lesson from the janitor, or just weird catchy things. I myself prefer to show the inner workings of the business from start to finish, kind of like a documentarian. Who's making a documentary going inner workings of a business and showing it, but I myself have particular ways of learning through education. So I believe that me being an educator, me being in the business of creating a private education company that teaches dating advice and self-actualization and dating level change, I believe there's particular things that I've learned through teaching, like how to teach. I myself am still always learning. One of my core values is continuing education, so I'm always interested in learning and having better ways of teaching, as opposed to someone who's making a documentary that's more interested in like the catchy entertainment. But I do believe that infotainment and the catchiness of entertainment is what captivates people on an entertainment level. And that's why I'm always making videos that are about that. And I'm also, you're gonna see like in a lot of my videos in the future, we're gonna have shows that are dedicated to that. I'm interested in making more videos that show my life and show like the entertainment going on in my life to educate people as well. But first and foremost, I wanted to build a channel that was based on just the core elements of education, because I believe that that's more important than entertainment. I believe in news today, most of the news is mostly about entertaining the world. And regardless of whether there's truths or truisms or learning lessons. Another subscriber is asking about mastermind groups and the power of how to create a mastermind group. Well, the easiest way to do that is to attend other people's mastermind groups. Now I do that, and that's how I built my mastermind group. I don't go to as many anymore because my Rolodex is so massive, I need to spend more time with these people. But the learning lessons that you have, the ability to have feedback and ask questions to those people that are really intelligent is even more valuable than just books or trying to study on your own. So if you look at movies like Good Will Hunting, the main character who Matt Damon played was talking about how his mentors were like Shakespeare. But his psychiatrist, who was in the movie, was saying, well, you can't ask questions to Shakespeare. These guys are all dead. Now, the power that you have today is that so many of these powerful, influential people are available to you and are wanting to help you. And you can learn from them directly. That's why there's such great value in just attending these mastermind groups. You could not just do that from mastermind groups that you attend or pay for. You could also reach out to people, cold approach. From the same skills that we cold approach people on a dating advice level, reaching people on, say, like a mastermind level, or just asking people to be your mentors, or just reaching out to people in general as a student, people like to reach out to you. Just being a student myself, me being a student from university, I can reach out to almost anyone, and almost anyone will be able to be reachable because everyone wants to help people, especially professors. Well, I love multitasking, so we ended up going shopping to a BNC camera while we were making this video. And I guess I just wanted to sum up by saying, when you're out there and you're trying to find out what to learn, use all the tools available to you, whether it's the books, the mastermind groups, the formal education, what have you. There's no better experience though than you going out and hitting the field. But at the same time, you don't want to make mistakes and you want to learn from other people's mistakes and lessons. I hope you enjoyed today's video today. Please subscribe to my channel. If you have questions below, please talk right below in the comments. I usually have a discussion back and forth, and I turn these questions and comments into the videos that we created to create today's videos and also all the future videos. But thanks for watching. Please share the video. Cheers.